Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. If you're new here, my name is Shah and I am a branding and web designer. But if you have watched any of my other videos, you will know how keen I am to create and build some new website templates going forward in 2026. And a few of the reasons why I want to focus on creating some templates is to use as a base for client projects, just to speed up my workflow, and also to sell and generate more passive income. So while I've been doing some research into new ideas and new templates, I thought it would be really useful to share some of my favorite web design trends specifically for templates in 2026. I actually do have a website template already up on Wix Studio, and not to be biased, but I actually do think Wix Studio has some of the best templates, both in their resource library, which are free templates that Wix Studio create, but they also have a Wix Studio marketplace, which is where I sell my template, and that's where I've been gathering most of my inspiration lately. And I've started to notice a few design trends that I love and I think make a lot of sense for templates going into 2026. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. These are my favorite web design trends for templates in 2026. Number one is maximalism, and I mean this in all sense of the word: bold colors, bold photography, lots of moving elements. And it's funny that I say this because when I first started my web design journey, I was a massive minimalism fan. Like, the way I would market my services was minimal design, and that was just something that I've always loved. But now I think we've seen so much of that, that having something stand out and be bold and show personality stands out way more in a world where there's so much going on the internet. With our attention spans at the moment, with all of these short form pieces of content that we consume, we need something that captures our attention. And I do think these kind of designs stop you in your tracks. Having said that, I will say this won't work for every single brand out there. I think it's really impactful when the brand allows for it. So something that I love and I feel like isn't exactly new, but at the same time, I still feel like not too many websites have features like this, and I think it's really important to have them, especially with all of the other things I mentioned before, with having short attention spans. We really want to grab the user's attention, and that is why this design trend is interactive hover elements. This could be things like hover reveals, button feedback, image transformations, or little micro surprises that make you want to keep interacting. It almost feels as if the website is responding to you and your mouse movements, and it gamifies the user experience, which I find really fun as a user, but also from a design standpoint, and people want to stay on the website for longer. And when you're browsing a website that feels fun to interact with, the user is more likely to continue clicking throughout the site, which leads to people clicking on more call to actions and ultimately leading to more conversions, which at the core is the main reason for any website. And I think a lot of people focus a lot on the design, which is really important for the brand and identity, but it doesn't mean anything if your site isn't converting and making the sales or doing the things that it's built to do. So when you can combine really thought out and fun design, which also then leads to conversions, I think that makes it perfect to use in a website, which is why I definitely want to continue using those in my templates for 2026. Number three is kind of similar in a way, because it does make the site feel interactive. And I've used this in pretty much all of my designs this year, so I thought I have to include this in a template for 2026. And that is sticky scrolling. And I just love how this makes a website feel less static. Like, there's nothing I don't like more than a static website. So instead of everything just passing by as a normal scroll would be, parts of the site actually stay with you. For example, sticky text that stays on one side with visuals that change as you scroll. An example of this is on a website that I actually created on Wix Studio Marketplace. And I really love this feature, so I'm gonna continue using it. I just like how it breaks down information. I think it works really well for storytelling. So something like an about page, or if you've got services to explain, that is a fun way that you can present them. And I feel like it gives structure to your scroll rather than just having content after content just stacked on top of each other. For templates especially, I just feel like this is a really great way to put enough information in the design without really overwhelming the user. Number four is all about menus and navigations. I feel like I'm tired of just having the menu be an afterthought. I feel like I've seen a lot of templates where they experiment with the navigation of the site. So instead of having like a normal full navigation menu, you've got the hamburger menu even on desktop and it pops up in a really fun way, or the text animates on in a fun way, whether it's a full screen menu or a half screen menu. I just feel like you can have a lot of fun with it and just have that as another branded section on your website rather than just sticking to the same mold. And when it is done well, I feel like it makes the website just feel more intentional as a whole. So I do think going to 2026, menus are gonna be part of the experience more rather than just a functional afterthought. Number five is something that I am extremely passionate about. And I think this makes or breaks a website design, and that is imagery. And I just know we are all overseeing the same stock imagery again and again and again. And there is really no excuse to not have strong imagery with the rise of AI, especially this year. You can put in some amazing prompts into things like ChatGPT and create the most amazing campaign images for any website, for any product. So I do think having strong imagery is so important to import into your design. And going back to the first one, which is maximalism, and how I don't think that necessarily works for every brand, I do think well thought out, strong visuals work for any brand, for any theme. If you wanna go for something minimal and you've got amazing photography that just tells a full story without having to do too much detailed design, with so many people using stock imagery, it is just like a guaranteed way that you're gonna stand out from the crowd. And especially with templates in 2026, I feel like a lot of templates you'll see on the market use stock imagery that you see over and over again. So if you wanna stand out with templates specifically in a marketplace where you're selling templates, use some really strong imagery that you can make yourself on AI platforms. Last but not least, in number six, is breaking the grid. So not having things so structured and having a layout that's more flowy. Again, this just feels like more of a design rather than a blocky static scroll. I'm so overseeing like the standard normal rectangular blocks on a website. I feel like that has to change, especially if you're not like a really corporate brand. I don't think there's any need to just stick to the rectangular blocks. I have seen some really cool templates where you scroll down and it kind of just like is a flowy design. It feels like the whole page has been designed in a really fun way rather than just like stacking of blocks. Here are a few examples that I actually really like and work well with this particular brand. And I just feel like the design feels more human and it adds movement without having to rely on loads of different animations and pop-ups on your screen if that's not something that you want to include. And then another big thing, especially when it comes to templates, is that it feels way more custom instead of like a cookie cutter template that you could buy anywhere, which I think is really important when it comes to buying templates. People don't want to buy something they feel like they've seen a million times. So that just adds a sense of uniqueness to the website. That is all of my favorite website trends that I have seen over and over again and that I love and I'm going to focus on when I make my templates in 2026. And I think these will really stand out when it comes to selling them and marketing them on the Wix Studio Marketplace, but also just as a base for client projects, like I said earlier, that I can go into a client project with a bit of a head start. I'm just picking out things that I feel like are really working currently that feel modern, but also timeless and work in real world situations, especially in a day and age of very short attention spans. And we're trying to grab attention quickly. So I hope these helped you if you're looking at creating templates in the new year or creating just any type of web designs and you're like looking for new inspiration. I would really recommend, if you haven't already, opening up a Wix Studio account and just browsing through their resources, browsing through their marketplace and getting some inspiration there as well. Let me know in the comments which trend is your favorite and if you've got any other web design trends that you want to add to this list. I am gonna wrap it up here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. I really appreciate it and I will see you guys in my next video. Sacrifice me, the curse I'm holding.